There are many ways to move in VR, and Demeo is a successful tabletop VR game that decided to use one of the more unique forms of locomotion called grab movement. Now, let's not waste any more time and learn how to do this ourselves. For this tutorial, I am going to be using my free VR template that I'll link in the description below. If you want to follow along in your own projects, you should be able to do that just fine. Starting off, I'm just going to duplicate my blank scene here, double-click it, Control-D, and I'm going to rename this. And then, yeah, double click, open it up, and see what we're working with here. So right now, it has a XR interaction main menu, no locomotion. So this isn't going to be able to move at all. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that. And you know what, if I look up XR... So if I look up XR setup, I should be able to find an XR setup. Now that I've dragged this in, let's see what we're working with here. So if we expand it out a little bit, it looks like it has a locomotion system already. And the really nice thing is, even though this is in my VR template or the one that I offer freely, this little prefab here is actually provided by the XR Interaction Toolkit 2.5.2. And you can see in the locomotion system, it actually already has a grab move provider there. But you know what? Let's build one from the ground up so we know how it works. So I'm gonna go ahead and toggle that off. I'll create a new empty object. Now the first thing I'm going to add is, well, a grab move provider. And you see here it's asking for a system, a locomotion system, so we can just drag that here. You can also see that it gives us a few options here. We can enable free movement along the X, Y, and Z axis, and I want it to be just like Demeo, so I'm going to have it on all three axes. Also going to have it use gravity, and then we have gravity application mode. So there's attempting to move, and then immediately. So what this means is, so since this has multiple moving systems, like continuous move, it will actually allow us to hover in the air for a little bit until we push forward the thumbstick. If we do immediately, as soon as we're done grabbing and moving, it'll just drop us to the ground. The controller transform, you know what, I'm going to have this be for the left controller. So I'm going to drag that there. Enable move while selecting. That just means we can grab things and then also still move at the same time. And then the move factor is how much we actually move relative to the controller. Finally, we need a reference. So we are going to grab the reference for the grab move. And this is going to be for the left hand. Let me expand this out so we can see it properly. There we go. Now, a question might come to your head, what button are we using for this? So it references this in the input actions. If we expand this out, it's just the grip button. That's it. So let's boot up and see if it's working. And you know what? Before I boot into anything, I'm actually going to add a few objects to the scene really quick because I just booted in and realized you can't really tell what you're doing without anything else in the scene. So give me a moment. Okay, I just added a bunch of cubes here so we can kind of see what's going on or if I'm moving at all. I'm in the scene, and if I hold the left grip button, I am able to kind of float in the air, but if I press the forward stick, I fall to the ground. So it is working. I can go side to side, forward and backwards. Now let's get the right controller going. Now for the right controller, it's going to be more of the same thing. So I'm just going to speed through this and add it really quick. All right, and so there we have it. It's all here now, but you know what? Instead of just hopping in, because we already know this works, so this is gonna work, we should now do the two-handed grab provider. So let me go ahead and grab that. Here we are. And so this provider is gonna coordinate with these two providers here and allow us to move and turn using both of these. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some things here that we already know. There we go, there's this. Here it's gonna ask for the references, so let's grab the left one and the right one. Next, so just going over a few of these things, override shared settings on initiation. So this will just override these guys with whatever their defaults are. We can also decide if we want to use both hands. So it would force us to use both grab buttons to move around. We can enable rotation, which I want, and then enable scaling. So sometimes you can give the option to grab objects and scale them when you're using both hands. And this would just allow you to do that while you're using the two-handed grab move provider. Alrighty, so I'm in the scene. And I hold the left grip and I move. I hold the right grip and I move. I hold both of them and I can move, but I can also rotate. So this is kind of working. One last bonus feature I want to cover before I send you off into the world so you can make millions of grab move providers is the vignette. So this kind of movement can be a little disorienting to some people, and well, you don't want them getting sick in your game. So if we open up the main camera, there is a tunneling vignette that's on here. And if you don't see it here, you should be able to find the prefab actually, because they provide it for you in, let's see here. There we go. Yeah, if you go to XR Interaction Toolkit 2.5.2, starter assets, and it should have a tunneling vignette that you can use. Now, I will mention that if you are using my VR template, I do have a custom script here that will break this. So this is a script that I made that saves settings from the title screen. That way it transfers over between scenes. So I'm just going to go ahead and turn that off, because by default, it's going to turn off the vignette. So the only thing we have left to do is make sure that our vignette is working. And you come down here and it's looking for locomotion vignette providers. And it already has a grab move provider. I'm going to drag it down here. And this is having a reference to the left grab move provider. Well, I guess it's using the one that they already have. But you know what? I'll connect it to my new one just to be complete with the tutorial. But the problem is, so since it is only referencing the left, then it's not going to reference the right, so it won't do a vignette when we use the right controller. And even funnier is if we use both hands to move, it won't work then too. So we need references to all three. So I'm going to add two more, and then I'm going to lock the screen here. I'm going to right click here, and I am going to add a new tab. Let's see here, inspector. I'm going to drag that here. So this is my new inspector. This one's locked down, so it's going to stay here. And then I'm going to find the new grab move provider. I'm going to make sure that I'm using the left one here. Scroll down, use the right one here, and then use the two-handed move provider. Okay, if I grab my left hand, you can see the tunneling is working. Right hand, it's working, and then the both. If I'm turning, it is working. So look at that. We are well on our way to making our own Demeo. I hope you all enjoyed this. Please consider liking and subscribing so I can reach more people out there. And to my Patreon subscribers, thank you. As always, without you, I can't do this. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.